Alright guys, so this video here, I'm going to walk through my Lingcod setups. This is pretty much what I'm going to be bringing to these charter boats here in the Bay Area. Everything I bring onto the boat, aside from the rods, is in this Yeti bucket right here. This Yeti bucket holds everything, my lunch, my baits, my lures, everything I need throughout the day, I put in this bucket. The first sort of top section here is primarily terminal tackle. I bring 60 pound mono and 80 pound mono. The 60 is for swim baits and the 80 is for trap rigs and three-way rigs. You gotta bring some three-way rigs and trap rigs because sometimes the conditions just aren't good for swim bait fishing. Here I got some hooks that I bring. These are some old bass punching hooks. I use these for my trap rigs. Some basic terminal tackle, you know, split rings, three-way swivels, quick clips for interchanging lures really quickly right here. These are the Spro quick clips. And then I got some barrel swivels, ball bearing or whatever swivels. A pretty simple terminal tackle stuff. Now, when it comes to trap rigging, if there's baby rockfish or even better sand apps, I'll definitely be fishing that. But a lot of times you don't have that. So I actually fish these sort of floating big bass swim baits. This is an 8-inch HUD, rate of fall zero. It's in rainbow trout color, but the Lingcod love this. Basically, this floating kind of swim bait just hovers behind the three-way rig, and with the little bit of swell on the bottom, it doesn't really get snagged up. This boot tail kicks with the slowest sort of movement, so Lingcod really like eating this stuff. So that's our three-way rig and terminal tackle. Now let's get into kind of what I'm throwing, I'd say, you know, 95% of the time on these boats, and that is swim baits. Right here is a construction belt. This is a tool belt for construction workers, I guess. Comes with this big clip right here. And when the boat stops and it's time to start fishing, I basically just take this entire setup out with all the lures I'm gonna be fishing that day or possibly fishing, and I clip this to the railing, and then that way I'm not going back to my bucket throughout the day. Let's jump right into the swim baits here. This is the first type of swim bait I throw. These are all underspins. This is made by a company called Coolbaits. And these jig heads right here come in 14.5 and 8 ounce. First off, do I think the underspins make a difference? I personally believe so. I've kind of caught more Lingcod next to people who weren't throwing with the underspins. It adds that little bit of flash, especially on the sunny days. Deep down, you know, in 180 plus feet, there's no really sunlight penetration in my opinion, but this little turning blade right over here on the bottom is gonna create some vibration. That vibration, I think, helps the Lingcod just kind of key in on it a little bit better and find the bait. You know, I throw this quite a bit in the 8 ounce. Usually when the swells are big, I'll throw the 8 ounce. If they get extremely big, I'll throw the 14.5. But the hook length on these jig heads are pretty long. So that's why I throw these 9-inch swim baits. These baits right here are the Madame Lures Big Hammers. They're 9 inches. The only color I buy nowadays is this blue mackerel color. I've just had so much good success on it with Lingcod. They all get bit. Some of these baits are pretty old that definitely had some bite marks on them. So that's my heavy side of my swim baits. Now let's talk about kind of the light side. I don't know if this is true for everybody else, but at the end of the day, if you want to catch more Lingcod on these charter boats here at NorCal, you know, Farallon Island, Point Reyes, stuff like that, the lighter of a swimbait head you can get away with, the better. That's just something I've noticed fishing next to people who had way more experience than me, and they fish, you know, 3-4 ounce heads and they flat out double the amount of Lingcod that I'm catching. Like, we're talking double digit counts. And ever since I switched to lighter heads, it's been like that for me too. These jig heads here, you'll notice I have a lot of them. We're gonna talk about these colors here as well. What the hell? What are you doing? So basically, these are D&M custom baits, Salty Dogs. That's the name of this jig or name of this underspin. They all come with a little blade. For these baits here, the reason I fish these jig heads is not so much that it's an underspin, but I just really like the components on these jig heads. So first off, it's a light wire jig hook. That wire, compared to these gaff looking wires, it's a lot thinner. we're fishing for Bay Area, California lingcod, you know? We're not fishing for Alaskan lingcod. You don't really need extremely heavy wire. I like these thinner wires. The thinner the hook wire, the easier it is for that hook to penetrate through the fish's mouth. So you don't need as much force on the hook set. Next thing I really like about these jig heads is there's two attachment points. You have a upright vertical one and you have a forward one. This one I use when I'm casting, which is probably 90% of the time. But every now and then I have sort of use cases for jigging it straight up under the boat, and this one helps with that. Lastly, the weed guard. People see this weed guard and they always say like, oh, that's pretty cool. You know, it helps rinse the weeds and the snagging up and stuff. What I like about this weed guard is I had issues with older, you know, more generic heads where the hook points would hit against rocks and they would start rolling. This weed guard kind of protects your hook point against those rocks, so you're not constantly sharpening up your hooks throughout the day. So like I said, that's why I really like these jig heads. I'll continue fishing them if I find something better. Now let's talk about the swim baits themselves. You'll notice I pretty much have these two colors right here. And that's because that's what I have confidence in. That's what catches lingcod day in, day out on these charter boats. You don't have to, you know, waste money buying all these different colors, in my opinion. I did that, and at the end of the day, this is what I've narrowed and filtered everything down to. First color is Christmas tree. These are big hammer 6.5 inch swim baits. The 6.5 inch are a little bit taller, which is why I like them over the 7 inch. The 7 inch are kind of thin profile and they break easier. So the 6.5 Christmas tree, really great color, especially in sunny conditions. I paired them up with 3.5, a 4.5, and a 6 ounce head, just depending on the depth and the current. Again, you wanna fish the lightest weight you can get away with. The next color is, again, big hammer as well, 6.5 inch, is this color called Hitch. Some websites will list it as Green Hitch, some will list it as Hitch, and some will even list it as Grunion. It is not the Grunion color. Be careful, I've definitely mistakenly bought a couple of these weird colors. It's a weird color to find. I don't know if it's like an error they have or what, but I just look for the Hitch color. It's got a little bit dark coffee, turquoise, and yellow, and I can throw this all day long, and I know I'll get bit on lingcod. So 6.5 inch, again, couple 6 ounce heads, 4.5, and a 3.5 ounce head. Cover all the different conditions. That's the swim baits that I'm gonna be bringing to the rail. And then right here, we got a bag of just extras. I've had days where you kind of get into a lot of lingcod, you know, more than 10 double digit counts. So you're going through swim baits. Again, if you look here, like I'm not kidding when I say like this is the color I have confidence in. I just bring a bunch of these Hitch colors. And that's pretty much all I throw. A couple of Christmas trees. This is the 7 inch. I was talking about how the 7 inch is thinner. I don't like that. I like the 6.5 inch. It's a little bit thicker. And then lastly, a damn lures blue mackerel. I'm serious when I say these are the only three colors I throw, guys. That's that. And then lastly, we gotta have a couple sinkers. So here's some sinkers I bring with me for 3A rigging and trap rigging. For me, I only kind of step towards the 3A rigs and trap rigs if it's too rough out and I can't fish a swim bait properly on the bottom anymore. You'll notice I'm not throwing 16 ounce. I'm actually kind of adding, linking them up together to make kind of 24 ounce or 30 ounce, stuff like that. And part of the reason is I learned this, you know, from watching other people who primarily 3A rig dead mackerel, and they flat out catch more than the whole boat combined in terms of lingcod. And they always use heavier weights than the people throwing the flies. It just gives them better control so your lines aren't wrapping around everybody else. Let's see what else we got here. Lastly, you know, bucket wise, we got some gloves here. We got some pliers. Pretty much that's it. At the end of the day, guys, like if you look at this, like I'm not trying to show you guys stuff that I bought that looks cool or catches the eyes of the angler. I'm showing you guys baits that get bit. Like if you look at the bite marks on this, it's completely chewed up by lingcod and rockfish. And that's one thing to mention is I've never had a charter trip out here where I didn't get my 10 rockfish limit. Usually I catch them fishing swim baits, the big rockfish especially, they will eat the swim bait. That's pretty much it in terms of my, what I'm throwing. This is literally what I'm bringing with me on the boat come like April, I guess in a couple of days here, season's about to open. Yeah. If you guys don't know where to start when it comes to lingcod fishing and you want to get into swim baits, hopefully this video kind of saves you some money. Don't get caught up in all those lures and million swimbait colors. Start with maybe some of these colors and just fish it. Don't put it down, you know. Don't switch back to flies to catch rockfish if you don't get bit. You do have to grind it out sometimes, but to me, catching big lingcod is way more fun than those rockfish. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any additional questions, let me know. Again, I'm gonna leave everything in the description below. Thanks for watching, and hopefully this helps some of you guys get started lingcod fishing.